guys, welcome to S-Academicus. So this is my video on deep foundations. So I have uploaded a few videos on foundations, like suitability of foundations. Then I have also uploaded a video on isolated foundation based on American code ACI 31805. So in this lecture I'll be talking about the pile foundations, types of pile foundations, the classification of pile foundation, and the installation methods and the construction of your pile foundations. So what is a pile foundation? So before going into the pile foundation, I'll just give a brief idea about the types of foundations. So basically we have two types of foundation based on the depth of the foundations. So based on the depth of the foundation, we have a shallow foundation and we have deep foundations. So shallow foundations, we mostly have isolated foundations, strip foundations, or sometimes a combined foundation, or we can have a complete raft foundation, like a complete building will be resting on a single raft where all the columns will be attached to that a single raft. So the shallow foundation may be isolated foundation, combined foundation, or a complete raft foundation. The deep foundations are basically piled foundations. Piled foundations, piles are nothing but slender columns which is resting below the ground. So the pile is nothing but a cylindrical column which is below the ground. So in this video I'll be talking about the pile foundation introduction. So introduction of pile foundations I'll be explaining, and classification of pile foundation based on a load transmission. So based on the load transmissions, what are the type of pile foundations? Based on the material of the foundations, based on the effect of soil. Also the introduction on a pile installation methods. So pile basically there are two types of pile installation methods. Either we have a pile driven piles or we have a bored pile. So pile driving methods and boring methods. And based on the constructions, so pile constructions, we have two types of pile. Either we have a cast in situ piles, which is being cast during the construction stage, or we can have a precast driven piles. So this is the overview of this tutorial. This tutorial where I'll be talking about these things which I have listed down. So the first is pile foundation introduction. So what is a pile foundations? Pile foundations are deep foundations. So pile foundations which when the site has a weak shallow bearing stratum. So pile foundations are deep foundations where the site has a weak shallow bearing stratum. That means the shallow level that is at a higher level, like up to 2 meters, 3 meters, the bearing stratum is very weak and the load need to be transferred deeper into the stratum. So when your shallow stratum, like when up to like 2 meters, 3 meters, or 3.5 meters, so these up to these depths, the stratum is, the soil bearing capacity is very less. So you, in order to transfer the load, you have to transfer those load into the deep stratums. So these are pile foundations, these are formed by long cylinder columnar elements. So pile foundations, if you'll see the figure of pile foundations, so these are nothing but a type of column which is below the ground and which is supported along all the sides with the help of soil. So they consist of two components. So as we can observe from the figure, the pile foundation consists of two components, a pile cap and a pile. Pile cap is the connection between a pile and a column. So the load from the column through the pile is transferred to the pile cap, and then these pile cap will transfer the load ultimately to the bearing stratum. So this is the function of pile and the components of a piled foundations. This type of foundation is used for either large structures and in situations where the soil is not suitable to excessive settlements. So as I said in the first point, so these are the foundations where your structure having heavy load structures, so the soil stratum has less bearing capacity, and also to prevent excessive settlement. So this is the requirement where you have to go for pile foundation. So a wide range of foundations types available which are suitable for different applications. So foundations, as I said, foundations are classified as shallow and deep. So in this lecture we are discussing about deep foundations. The pile foundations are deep foundations which are formed by long cylinder columnar elements, as I said. So pile foundations are basically classified according to the based on load transmission, then based on material of pile construction, based on effect of the soil. So firstly we'll talk about the classification of pile based on load transmission. So this is the most important criteria. This is the most important criteria of classification of pile foundation, that is load transmission. So based on the load transmission, we have end bearing piles and friction pile. So what is end bearing piles? You can see these two figures. This one is end bearing piles and this is friction pile. So in common terms, we can by this end bearing pile we can conclude that the end will provide certain bearing capacity to this soil, to this pile. So other classifications are very simple, but this is the most important. You have to understand this classification. So end bearing piles, we can see that the pile tip settling on a hard bearing strata such as limestone, which carries the load on the pile. So in this end bearing piles, the pile will rest in a hard strata. But in this friction pile, the bearing capacity of pile will be based on the negative friction developed due to the surrounding soil. So cohesive soils actually grip the sides of the piles with friction. So this is similar to when you step in a muck. Try to pull your foot out and it pulls off your shoes. So that is just an example how this friction pile behaves. So friction piles are generally advised where you don't have a hard strata. Like if your hard strata, you cannot find the hard strata up to 20 meters or below 30 meters. So these friction piles are basically very long, and end bearing piles are generally rested upon the hard strata. It is penetrated up to certain depth in the hard strata. Like IS 2911 has a clause where if you have a hard end bearing pile, then your pile should be anchored at a length of 2 times dia of your pile, or between the range of 2 times dia of your pile to up to 4 times dia of your pile. So you have to anchor your pile in the hard strata. So end bearing piles actually transmit most of their loads to the load bearing layer, which can be dense sand or rock. So most of the pile capacity is inferred from the end bearing point. As I mentioned, the pile capacity is from the end bearing point. And the friction piles generally transmit their load through the layers through which the piles pass. So these are the surrounding soil which impart the bearing through negative friction, which is also called as skin friction with the surrounding soil. So this is the most important types of this is the most important criteria for classification of your pile. The other criterias which are your based on material, these are very simple because you can just easily identify the type of pile, or it is based on the availability. Like steel piles, if your concrete, the concrete is not easily available, or the construction of concrete pile is not easily. So other type of piles are classific. Other type of classification of pile is generally based on the feasibility or availability or the manufacturing. But this type of classification, that is load transmission, it is totally based upon the soil condition of that region. So hope this the classification based on load transmission is clear, because this is the most important type of classification you'll come across with these two terms while actual designing. So end bearing pile or friction pile. So friction pile are mostly very long compared to your end bearing, because in end bearing we get the hard strata at not much lower depth. Like you can get the hard strata at even 4 meter depth, 5 meter depth, 6 meter depth, 8 meter depth, 15 meter depth. But friction piles up to it will be mostly at your desired pile capacity. Like if you desire a pile capacity of 30 tons for vertical loading, so the 30 ton capacity at the depth where you achieve the 30 ton capacity, that depth will be your up to which your pile should be running. That is the length of the pile. So it may be you are getting a 30 ton capacity at 20 meter depth or 25 meter depth or 30 meter depth or even 15 meter depth, based upon the cohesive nature of the surrounding soil. Next type of classification is is based on materials. So you have timber piles or wooden piles, steel piles, concrete piles and composite piles. So steel piles, timber piles or wooden piles, just you can have a look. These are wooden piles, these are steel piles. So steel piles comes under different sections. Like you can have these are H type H sections. You can also have a box type of pile. You can have a circular tube type of pile. So you can have different sections for steel piles. Concrete piles, again I'll be explaining further in detail. Concrete piles, you can have circular, rectangular, or you can have square. You can also have the shape as per requirement. But augured piles are also there, which augured shape. So concrete piles you can have based on materials. Then comes composite piles. Composite piles are those piles where the pile is made of two materials. Like you can have a concrete timber pile, you can have a steel concrete pile, you can also have timber, steel. You can, as per your requirement, based on your composition. So composite piles are piles where you can have two or more type of material in a single pile. So based on the effects on soil. So we have driven piles and bored pile. So driven pile and bored piles, I'll be talking in this pile installation method, where pile driving methods and boring methods are explained. So pile driving methods are and boring methods. Driving methods are just you have a precast pile which is hammered into the soil, and boring methods is your basically your bore, your pile is bored in the and cast in situ, mostly cast in situ. So pile based on construction. So those driven piles and boring piles I'll be explaining in this pile construction method. So we have, based on construction, we have the cast in situ piles and we have pre-cast piles. So cast in situ piles are hammered cast in situ piles have these four, actually you can have these basic steps, where a thin wall steel tube is hammered into the ground, then all the earth left is removed, left inside the tube is removed, then a steel reinforcement cage into the tube. and then the concrete is being poured into. So basically this cast in situ piles are, you have to just drill, you have to just hammer a thin wall steel tube, it is called a casing. Then after putting the casing, all the earth is removed from inside the tube. Then the reinforcement cage is lowered into the tube, and then the pouring of wet concrete and then settlement. So you can, this figure will explain it properly. So this, if you can see, this is the first step where your tube is inserted deep into the ground. You can see, then all the soil is taken out. Then your steel cage, that is reinforcement cage, is lowered down the tube, and then the concrete is being poured. So this is the cast in situ pile. Then next is your precast or driven pile. So machine holds the pile perfectly vertical and then hammers it into the ground blow by blow. Each blow is struck by lifting a heavy weight and dropping it on the top of the pile. So while every blow, the pile need to be covered with steel cap to prevent it from disintegrating, so that the pile should not get distorted in case of your precast concrete piles. Because concrete being a brittle material, if you keep on giving a blow at this point, your pile may start disintegrating. So in order to prevent the disintegration of the pile, there is a steel plate which is provided at the top of pile, so that the pile does not get damaged. So this is a typical driven pile system. Like you can see, this is the column, this is a pile cap, and this is a group of piles. So we can see two piles. So this is the method where a pile is driven into the soil using a heavy load machine. So this is how precast driven piles are driven into the ground with the help of heavy machine. So this was regarding the introduction of pile foundations. Different type of pile foundations we have discussed. What is pile foundation and classification of pile foundations. We have discussed about pile construction of pile foundation, like we have discussed cast in situ pile and driven precast pile. So I have uploaded a video on pile design of pile based on Indian standards, so you can refer those. I'll be coming up with more videos on foundations. I'll be coming up with a pile foundation design. So please follow, please subscribe, and please share our videos. If you have any doubt, you can comment. We will try to clarify your comments. We will try to make videos based on your suggestions. So this was a very brief introduction regarding pile foundations. If you have any doubt regarding pile foundations, you can comment. For pile foundations, you can use IS 2911. IS 2911 is the Indian standard for pile designing, for different types of pile designing. So IS 2911 has different parts. So you can refer for precast piles. There is different part. Cast in situ, we have part. We have this pile test. We have different part. So these are the basically you have to follow IS 2911 for your pile design. In case you have any doubt, you can comment. Please subscribe to our channel and please keep sharing our videos. Thank you. Have a nice day and goodbye.